Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Charlene Israel. A deadly weekend across the nation's midsection as a series of tornadoes ripped through Iowa, Kansas, and Oklahoma. At least one person was killed and more than 20 injured. And forecasters say more tornadoes could hit that same region. Dale Hurd has the story.
Nearly 50 violent tornadoes hammered America's heartland, one powerful storm after another. From Kansas to Oklahoma.
Yeah, we're good. It's on the ground.
The twisters launched massive amounts of debris into the sky as they carved deadly trails across the open plains. Ominous funnel clouds dropped from the sky and supersized hail pelted drivers on the roads.
It was very scary.
A massive tornado pulverized homes and killed at least one man in a mobile home park southeast of Oklahoma City. High winds ripped up power lines and tossed tractor trailers off highways like toys, sending their cargo flying. In Kansas, the hail was so strong it took the paint off homes.
The wind is just unbelievable how the hail and everything was just coming straight sideways.
At this campground, RVs and their owners got badly battered as well.
The wind just came up all of a sudden and the RV started shaking. I'm thankful that we weren't hurt more than we were.
Over in Texas, Christy Green is thankful she and her son are still alive. They were taken airborne by a twister last week.
I prayed to God. I said, please, I cannot take another minute. Please just stop it.
And God answered her prayer. Many more could have been killed by such a deadly army of tornadoes.
No one got hurt, and we're all safe. You know, God was with us.
Dale Hurd, CBN News.
CBN's Operation Blessing is coordinating relief efforts for tornado victims in Granbury, Texas. The town was hit last week by an EF4 twister, packing winds up to 200 miles per hour. Six people were killed and as many as 100 were injured in that town west of Dallas. Many homes in two neighborhoods obliterated. Operation Blessing is working alongside residents to remove huge piles of debris. OB is also partnered with dozens of churches and volunteers from across the state coordinating delivery of donated relief supplies. Survivors are grateful for the help and thankful to be alive.
I broke an elbow. It's just amazing. It's just amazing. Took my pickup, my car. It took everything we're trying to rebuild because we lost everything in 2008 and we started all over. And we started in a 30-foot camper and built our way back up to a house, a trailer house. And now it's gone. But we're alive.
OB is also working with a team of Home Depot associates. The Obama administration is trying to regain its footing after a tidal wave of scandals swept the administration last week. White House senior advisor Dan Pfeiffer insisting on weekend news shows that the administration had no knowledge of the IRS's targeting of conservative groups. Republicans, meanwhile, charged that intimidation is part of a pattern in the Obama White House.
No, but don't take my word for it. Take the word of the independent inspector general, who said that he found no evidence that there was any influence from anywhere outside of the IRS.
Given the trend line we're seeing here, Bob, in so many different instances, it's unfortunately a culture, I think, in the administration that it's okay to cover these things up. And part of it has to do with the intimidation that the administration is using against some of its critics. It is a culture of cover-ups and intimidation that is getting the administration in so much trouble.
Meanwhile, Republicans continue to investigate the Obama administration over what led to the terrorist attack in Benghazi last year. Senator Rand Paul says former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton needs to take responsibility.
She was asked repeatedly to provide security in Benghazi on several occasions, including direct cables, and she says she never read the cables on security. I find that inexcusable and a dereliction of duty. Whether it has political overtones or not, it really goes to the heart of who you are as Secretary of State. If you do not provide security for an embassy that's begging for it, that's absolutely a dereliction of duty, and she should have resigned and accepted blame for it.
Former IRS Commissioner Stephen Miller appears before the Senate Finance Committee to answer more questions about that scandal on Tuesday. The Associated Press continues to lash out against the government's secret subpoena of reporters' phone records. The president and CEO of AP says what the Justice Department did was unconstitutional and that it has already had an effect on news gathering. Sources are now much less willing to talk to AP journalists. The Justice Department says it was conducting an investigation into how AP learned about an Al-Qaeda bomb plot in Yemen before it was made public last year. While all these scandals could spell another problem for the president, it could mean that the end of what some have called a cozy relationship with the mainstream media. David Brody has that story from Washington.
As the scandals pile up, the mainstream media is slowly turning on the Obama administration, whether it be the IRS targeting conservative groups.
You have to understand and hear how it sounds like the administration might be hiding something.
Or the Justice Department secretly seizing phone records of Associated Press reporters.
It's chilling. I guess they owe us an explanation.
Even his biggest supporters are heading for the door. This is MSNBC commentator Chris Matthews a year ago on President Obama.
Everything he's done is clean as a whistle. He's never not only broken any law, he's never done anything wrong. He's the perfect father, the perfect husband, the perfect American.
Fast forward to the present.
He doesn't want to know about them. He doesn't want to run the United States government. And that has been the problem. Why isn't he angry, really angry, about what happened with the IRS?
If you're the president, this is not a good sign. Now, the media is also coming around on what happened in Benghazi after the death of American ambassador to Libya, Chris Stevens. Only CBS reporter Cheryl Atkinson pursued this from the beginning, long before her mainstream colleagues. She sat down exclusively with CBN News.
The media is not always consistent in the vigor that they use to pursue a given topic. And I do think the media did not use the opportunity in the weeks and months after Benghazi to be as persistent and as pointed as they should have, considering the importance of the issue, in my view.
Atkinson says she's definitely received pushback from the White House.
The White House called about an article I wrote a week or so ago. They personally pushed me back. You know, I'm used to that, so that's their job. Sometimes the harder they push, the more I believe maybe we're mining fertile area.
Atkinson has been applauded by conservative groups for her tenacious reporting. She says CBS executives supported her coverage despite having a tough time getting her Benghazi stories on television.
Every story that you present as a reporter has to be bought by a broadcast, meaning not purchased for money, but you have to get them interested in it. So maybe Evening News wants one story, Morning News wants a story. And there hasn't been an appetite for the stories I've offered on Benghazi.
The perfect storm of Benghazi, the IRS, and the AP phone log story leads to an even larger question.
You think there's a disappointment to a certain degree within liberal camps?
I think there's a huge disappointment.
Washington Post columnist Dana Milbank recently wrote that, quote, 100 days into his second term, Obama has already lost control of the agenda, if he ever had control in the first place. Milbank tells CBN News that Obama's lifeless, submissive attitude has hurt him.
It struck me that it was just very oddly passive for this president who had just won a second term to be sort of resigning himself to that and saying, I'll just see what they do up there. You know, there's only so much I can do. I'm going to wash my hands of the whole thing. It was odd for him not to be, I think, out there fighting more for his agenda.
Now it seems like the only fighting this president is doing is fighting off scandal after scandal. David Brody, CBN News, Washington.
Some conservative Hispanics have also complained about the IRS's actions. George Rodriguez is the former president of the San Antonio Tea Party. He tells Fox News that when they applied for nonprofit status, they were intimidated by IRS workers with excessive paperwork and meddling questions. Rodriguez says, quote, it was flat out dirty politics. A horrifying new abortion story is emerging out of Houston, Texas. Abortionist Douglas Carpin is being accused of performing illegal late-term abortions similar to the ones that Kermit Gosnell was convicted of last week. Texas Lieutenant Governor David Dewhurst is comparing the accusations to the Gosnell case. Dewhurst said, I read with disgust about the allegations of Houston-based abortionist Douglas Carpin performing illegal late-term abortions surrounded by appalling sanitary conditions in his clinic. He's calling for a full-scale investigation. Coming up, if disaster strikes, one group is always ready. We'll take you inside the world of doomsday preppers.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 U.S. gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? In this first basket is what my $20 bill buys: milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy: 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So, class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
Help! If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry, they have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than a dollar a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
From CBN.
Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum, you and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute.
Superbook.
No.
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen. Plus, 2 copies to share with others. All for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah.
Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him! He is alive!
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
The sun unleashed 4 major solar flares over just a few days last week. That's very rare. Thankfully, the flares were on a side of the sun that wasn't facing Earth. Otherwise, they could have dealt a huge blow to the Earth's electronic infrastructure. Still, one AccuWeather astronomer reports these flares disrupted some satellite communications, even causing a few blackouts lasting up to 25 minutes. Solar storms have the potential to interact with the Earth's magnetic field, causing radio blackouts, disrupting satellites and GPS signals, and in extreme cases, disrupting power grids. Well, are you ready for a major natural disaster, a crippling economic crisis, or even a long power outage? There is one group of people prepared for catastrophes, big and small. They're called preppers, and they're growing in number. Chuck Holton has that story.
We can have an economic collapse. We can have terrorist attacks. We can have social unrest, a natural disaster, earthquakes, tsunamis, hurricanes.
Keith Eiten is a diehard prepper and recently started a business helping others get ready too.
The biggest problem we suffer here in North America is complacency. People figure since, nothing has happened in X amount of years, nothing bad will ever happen.
You know, survivalists are sometimes portrayed as these wild-eyed crazies waiting for the zombie apocalypse. But with the state of the economy and in today's world, being prepared is more popular than ever. In the mountains of North Carolina, a couple thousand people got together at the Carolina Readiness Seminar to discuss the risks and find out what they can do about them.
It's very environmental, very green, takes us off of fossil fuels, and very easy to do.
Joel Henderson is the co-owner of Green Gold Filters, one of the vendors at the Prepper Convention. His patented filtration system is helping folks accomplish something that America has been trying to do for years, run a vehicle without foreign oil.
If anybody has a diesel engine, diesel truck, tractor, generator, you can use used cooking oil as an alternative diesel fuel or motor oil. If you go to the restaurants, this right here is a local restaurant here in Asheville, Indian restaurant, and this is their used cooking oil that they were throwing away. We went and picked it up, ran it through our filter system, and now we have a nice alternative diesel fuel that I'll put right in my tank.
This movement is being helped along by a new trend in television shows about the subject. The most popular is National Geographic's Doomsday Preppers.
Doomsday Preppers is the highest rated show right now ever on National Geographic. It's a show about, you know, your average American family, unique people that are prepping for any of life's uncertainties, whether that be an economic collapse to a solar flare. No matter what it is, they're going to be prepared.
One of the challenges for the show is that most preppers aren't eager to advertise their stockpiles of supplies, since if the bottom drops out, looting could be a real problem.
You know, we do understand that, you know, it could be a risk to people, but we do respect people's privacy on the show. We don't have to say your first name or last name. We don't have to say where you're from, and we try to get in the lives of many diverse preppers and have each prepper, you know, give a takeaway to our viewers so they can learn more about prepping.
But Keith Eiten says the first step to being prepared has nothing to do with canned food or bottled water.
Your first thing in preparedness, for me personally, is your relationship with Jesus Christ. That's the very first thing. If you build a solid relationship with Jesus Christ, then after that, if you can get food, water stored away, a little safe retreat, things of that nature, it'll all fall into place. You want to be able to feed yourself, feed your family, help a neighbor, help a friend.
You know, 100 years ago, it wasn't strange for a family to have a basement full of food, but that's changed. Most Americans today have less than 3 days' supply of food stored up, and many have no emergency supplies or even a first aid kit. But you know, with the infrastructure of America getting more and more fragile every day, maybe it's not a bad idea to stock up, just in case. From an undisclosed location in North Carolina, I'm Chuck Holton for CBN News.
Up next, inside a Romanian gypsy village where poverty is rampant, how one group is reaching out with hope.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Bibles have been reinstated in Georgia State Park lodges and cabins. They were removed after an atheist guest complained. Officials instructed staff to remove the Bibles while the issue was being investigated. The move didn't go over well with many conservative groups in Georgia.
We are guaranteed a freedom of religion, not freedom from religion. And as far as I'm concerned, this is very intolerant.
Georgia Governor Nathan Deal ordered the Department of Natural Resources to return the Bibles. In a statement, he said that no laws were violated because the Bibles were donated by outside groups and not by the state. For much of the 20th century, Romania suffered under the harsh rule of a communist dictator. About 25 years ago, a revolution brought economic and political freedom to the country, allowing many to move forward. For one segment of the population, however, liberty and prosperity remain just a dream. But as Ephraim Graham reports, the country's gypsies are experiencing a wealth that money can't buy.
Oradea is 8 miles from Romania's border with Hungary. And more than 20 years after the fall of communism, city streets are as busy as any other Eastern European town at rush hour.
And in a developing country, especially now one that's a member of the European Union, you know, you would expect everywhere to be moving forward at some pace or another.
But great expectations aren't always reality. It's a lesson learned for Kevin Hoy after years of missions work in Romania.
But what you realize as you travel around is that so many of the gypsy communities haven't moved forward at all. They're exactly where they were, whether it's 10 years ago, 20 years ago.
In the gypsy village of Szilard, people have spent generations away from the rest of Romanian society.
The way they've been brought up, you know, like from generations, they would follow their immediate needs, but then be unable to see the perspective.
This gypsy village is actually one of the poorest in the area. Homes like the one behind me are made of mud brick. You can take a look and you see it's not sturdy at all, easy to crumble. This is also an area where children don't have the opportunity to go to school, and that can make it rather difficult to dream. Dreams of a better life are even more difficult for the adults, like Robert Maguri, who says it's too late to even think about an education.
I think the only way I can make some money is to be there when people need us to help them picking the crops and so on.
Hope can be hard to find in this gypsy village.
Sometimes they might be violent, not to me, not to us, but to each other.
Education is a big factor, but prejudice also plays a major part in the fact they're just trapped. And whatever we're trapped by, you know, in the end of the day, the truth of the gospel can release us.
Kevin and his team see the reality of that truth just a few miles away, here in the Tilag Gypsy Village, once known for crime and violence.
For a while, especially when I wasn't a Christian, I was really angry on these people, you know, knowing that they put a bad sign, a bad mark on my country.
This gypsy village is home to about 40 families. That's roughly 500 people, and it's seen a lot of changes since the year 2000. That's the year Kevin Hoy met a young gypsy begging on the streets.
We were on our way to eat. This little boy was hungry. He came with us. Over the 2 hours, we learned a lot about his community, his family, and he ended up taking us back to meet his mom and dad and his 8 brothers and sisters.
We were shocked to see them on our door. I was with one of my kids in my arms. And I asked my child, who are these people? And he was like, they are my friends.
Now that little boy has children of his own. And in the last 10 years, that friendship produced running water for the village, a neighborhood store, a school, and even a church where gypsies have come to Christ.
For sure, God's people would be looking to help gypsy communities.
The Tilag Gypsy Village is part of a growing gypsy revival. It's a story documented by Tudor Patan and Romania's Alpha Omega television network.
God, in his mercy, decided now to work with strong power to these groups marginalized for centuries here in Europe. And it's a sign for me that the time is very short.
Patan witnessed what many call the Toflia miracle. In southeast Romania, 500 gypsies were baptized after accepting Christ in 2009, the largest baptism in Romania's history at the time. Recording artist Daniel Dinescu led worship.
We gypsies have singing in our blood, but this has nothing to do with our faith. We sing from our hearts because we were a marginalized people.
Hundreds more have answered the call to Christ through the ministry. Kevin Hoy now prays revival will soon reach the residents of Szilard. But in the meantime, he and his team preach the gospel without words.
We could talk to them all day long and they wouldn't be able to grasp what it is we're trying to say. Practical evidence of God's love is what the people need.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Oradea, Romania.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. That it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window, yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Finally today, a mother in a Philadelphia train station jumped on the tracks to save her daughter. This happened when her daughter's stroller rolled away and fell onto the tracks. Take a look at this surveillance video. The mother looks away for just a moment and the stroller rolls and falls. The 14-month-old still strapped inside. It only took 7 seconds. Without hesitation, the mother jumps to the rescue. You can see a woman push an emergency call button as a bystander jumps into action to pull the child back to safety while another jumps onto the tracks to help the mother.
It's heart-wrenching because you can anticipate it. It's one of our busiest lines, and our trains run quite often. In this case, the stroller went into the track area at a time when, fortunately, there were no trains running.
Thank God. Well, fortunately, the train was just one station away. The toddler only suffered cuts to her forehead. She is expected to recover soon. Thank God for that. Well, that's all for now on the CBN News Channel. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com. And tell us what you think about the stories you've seen today. You can do that on Facebook or at CBN News on Twitter. Hope you join us next time. Have a great day. God bless.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free, no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com. Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. The CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.